rheumatoid arthritis, right? Rheumatoid arthritis. So rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disorder which is an autoimmune in origin, right? So chronic inflammatory disorder, autoimmune in origin. So always remember, rheumatoid arthritis is an chronic inflammatory disorder. It is a chronic inflammatory disorder, right? Chronic inflammatory disorder, and they are autoimmune in origin. Commonly, as I have told you, ki autoimmune disorders are commonly affecting which gender? Female. So here also females are commonly affected than male, but age group will be little higher here also. 40 to 60 years of age group is commonly affected. So chronic inflammatory autoimmune disorder, females 40 to 60 years of age group will be commonly affected, right? Here we need to understand few important things. Already we have discussed, when you will see the etiology, as I have told you, genetic factors are associated. So just I wanted to recall you that they are strongly associated with HLA-DR4, right? So this was All India question. That is why I wanted you to recall this. HLA-DR4 is most strongly associated MSC molecule, most strongly associated HLA molecule with rheumatoid arthritis. And another important thing is PTPN22 gene polymorphism is also associated with this disorder. So that is what I have said that time, ki PTPN22 gene polymorphism is the most common gene associated with autoimmunity, right? So these two points we have to keep in mind for autoimmune disorder, rheumatoid arthritis. So in rheumatoid arthritis, when you are seeing the clinical feature, when you are seeing the clinical feature, what you are understanding, ki characteristically they will be having bilateral symmetrical involvement, right? So bilateral symmetrical involvement of larger joint or smaller joints? So answer is smaller joints. So bilateral symmetrical involvement of smaller joints will be seen in rheumatoid arthritis, right? And usually, see what I'm writing, usually, not always, usually they will spare distal interphalangeal joint. So usually this will be sparing distal interphalangeal joints, right? So bilateral symmetrical joint involvement will be there. So characteristic presentation, when this person will wake up in the morning, he will have some stiffness. But when he will start working, that stiffness will be relieved. So with the work, or you can say when he will acquire work, that pain will be relieved. So that is how it differs from the osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis, with the work it will aggravate, with the work it will be relieved. So that is the one characteristic clinical feature, right? So here what I wanted to tell you, what are the important findings in this rheumatoid arthritis which examiner can ask. So what are the characteristic clinical finding which examiner ask here in fingers, right? So when I will talk about hands and fingers. So there are three important findings which we are going to discuss for rheumatoid arthritis. Number one finding is called as swan neck deformity. So what is the swan neck deformity in finger, right? So what is the swan neck deformity? Swan neck deformity, when you will see a finger, it will be like this. This is the proximal joint, right? Sorry, this is the distal interphalangeal joint, right? And then I am showing you, this is the proximal interphalangeal joint, and this is the hand, right? So suppose I am showing you just a diagrammatic representation. This is the hand, right? So what I am showing you in swan neck deformity, it is like a swan, right? In swan neck deformity, what will be the finding? Swan neck deformity, distal interphalangeal joint is having flexion, right? So they are having hyperflexion, and proximal interphalangeal joint will be having hyperextension. So that is the important thing to remember here, is swan neck deformity, hyperflexion of the distal interphalangeal joint and hyperextension of the proximal interphalangeal joint, that will be called as swan neck deformity. So this is the number one, swan neck deformity. Number two is called as Boutonniere deformity. So what we will see in Boutonniere deformity? In Boutonniere deformity, you will observe that this is the distal interphalangeal joint, and this is the proximal, proximal interphalangeal joint and distal interphalangeal joint. So what we are observing here, in this case we will see distal interphalangeal joint is having hyperextension and proximal interphalangeal joint will be having hyperflexion. So increased flexion will be present. So this is very important. This diagram is very important because examiner will ask about any deformity, what will be DIP, what will be PIP, right? So DIP is hyperextension, and proximal interphalangeal joint is hyperflexion. So that is Boutonniere deformity, right? When you are going to see X-ray report of this patient in rheumatoid arthritis, what is characteristic finding you will notice? You will notice that there is a radial deviation. So this will be having radial deviation of the wrist joint, right? So see what I have drawn here. On X-ray finding, you will be seeing the same picture which I am showing you. You will notice that there is a radial deviation. You can see what I am showing you here. It is the radial deviation of the wrist, right? So wrist will be showing radial deviation. So radial deviation of wrist will be seen in case of rheumatoid arthritis, radial deviation. Whereas fingers, if you observe, fingers are showing ulnar deviation. So fingers are showing ulnar deviation. So ulnar deviation will be present in fingers. So these are the important findings which you will see clinically, right? So now I would like to show you these pictures which I have shown you, right? That is how examiner can ask you, right? So now what we are seeing, this is the distal interphalangeal joint, and you can see this is the proximal interphalangeal joint, right? So distal interphalangeal joint is having hyperflexion and proximal is having hyperextension. So what is this? This is swan neck deformity, right? So this is swan neck deformity. So what I am showing you here, this is called as swan neck deformity, right? Now look at this one. In this picture, what we are observing, see, this one is the distal interphalangeal joint and this one is the proximal interphalangeal joint. So distal is having hyperextension, proximal is having hyperflexion. So this type of deformity is called as Boutonniere deformity, right? So this is called as Boutonniere deformity, which we have discussed, right? When you will see the X-ray finding, now look at this. This is the thumb area. So you can see the wrist joint, right? Wrist joint is moving towards the radius. So radial movement is there, whereas ulna is here, and you can see the fingers, they are moving towards ulnar side. So wrist is radial side, fingers towards ulnar side, right? So this will be the characteristic finding in case of rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis, when we will go for diagnosis, so that time we will be seeing two important things. One is biopsy, one is serology. So diagnosis, we will notice two things: biopsy and serology. Biopsy, what are the findings you will observe in rheumatoid arthritis? In biopsy, number one, you will see there will be a characteristic named structure which is called as pannus. So pannus is characteristic in or seen in rheumatoid arthritis. What is pannus? Right, so I would like to show you. Suppose I am showing you, this is the articular cartilage. Just for the diagrammatic representation, I am trying to show you. This is the articular cartilage, right? So this is the
articular cartilage. So articular cartilage will be there.
What is pannus? It's a swollen or edematous synovium. So what I said,
what is pannus? It's a swollen. So I am showing you a swollen
edematous synovium.
So this is the swollen or edematous, swollen or edematous or edematous synovium. So swollen or edematous synovium,
which will be present, this is called pannus. What will be present inside this swollen synovium?
They will be rich in inflammation. So they will be having inflammatory cells, they will be having fibroblasts, inflammatory cells, fibroblasts, and they will be having granulation tissue, granulation tissue. So these are three things which are present in the pannus.
So what is pannus?
Pannus is a swollen edematous synovium.
What is pannus? If examiner asks you,
what is pannus? Pannus is a swollen edematous synovium.
What they are doing? They are overlying over the articular cartilage and causing their erosion. So they are overlying. So now you can see they are lying over, they are lying over the articular cartilage,
and after that they will be causing destruction of the articular cartilage. So this is how we have to understand about pannus.
So pannus is the synovial structure which is swollen and they are overlying over the articular cartilage, which will be consisting of inflammatory cell, fibroblast and granulation tissue. And these inflammatory cells
will be causing destruction of the articular cartilage.
And that is why whenever you will see their x-ray, there will be erosion of the bone, right? Osteopenia will be finding, right? So because of this only there will be articular damage or erosion or osteopenia will be present in this patient.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.